Hi, I'm Patricia McNeely, and this is a continuation of my videos on twin flames and how we're merging and some of the process of what's been going on behind the scenes and the energies that you're all feeling. So, we're going to talk right now about the earth energies, earth connections, the people, places, things. We are twin flames, which means we're lovers. And what do lovers do? We love, we make love. We are the ones that make love, that fuel everything. What we have needed, however, has been our own personal safety and the safety of our surroundings, our environment. Whether it's where we live, where we work, where we like to play, our families, and everything we've been experiencing in the past few years has been towards that end, so we can be in love, have it be safe and loving. Now, what was one of the first things that we needed to do? Well, anytime you have something new, you need to clean out the old, and that's what we've been doing. We've been working on the old people, places, and things, removing all of the old. Now, what does this mean? This means that we've had new laws enacted. We've actually wished for those laws, taken actions to let our government know that we want these things. Not everything we wished for is in place, but it's picking up momentum and gradually is getting there. So we have new laws in place. We have expanded benefits. Some countries have more than others. Some of them are still getting on board. Here in the United States, where you're still having growing pains. The other thing is we are moving old structures. These are non-life structures. They're corporations sometimes, but not always. They are governmental structures, religious structures. There are things that have been supporting us, but which no longer support who we are and who we're becoming. So, for example, the entire military will continue to be decommissioned and transformed into true ambassadors of peace. It's a process. We're not going to flip a switch and have it happen overnight. It requires everybody's help. The old religious structures will continue to dismantle regardless of affiliation. I myself have been raised Roman Catholic here in Chicago, and that's been our social structure here for many people because of the immigrants who came over from Europe to populate here. But it no longer serves who we are. I personally had quite a bit of a struggle to let it go because, you know, it was where you can go have a pancake breakfast and where you could go sing and where you could meet people and where you could go, you know, hear confessions or tell your confession. But we've come to realize we no longer need these third-party structures to assist who we are. And that may be hard for some people. It may be like cutting off your arm because it's been such a support in other ways. But please know that you are supported, you are loved. There are other things moving into place that are here to support you and love you. There are laws that are moving into place to serve you and love you, such as marriage laws. Not everyone can get married in every state, but that's taking on momentum. And what does this mean? Well, as we've unplugged the old, we've plugged in the new. And it looks a little bit something like this. I need a diagram that will show kind of where things are at, where people have kind of been. This is intended to be a female-male person twin flame and their counterpart, the male-female person twin flame. What we've done is we've taken everything that's unusable and we've gotten rid of them through the black hole. And you might say, wow, black holes really do exist. Yes, they do. And for people with certain connections, they are the people that transmute that and send unusable energies into the black hole. What are these unusable energies? There are things like birth defects, sexual diseases, mental diseases. We've already created the pathways for those to be destroyed and never used again in our bodies. Now, is that to say everyone's instantly cured? No. What that means is that people can now avail themselves of faster and faster healing processes, as long as they don't put the limits on it. What have we done here? We've taken all the usable energies, which perhaps females have had inherent to them, or males have had inherent to them, and we transmuted those for recycling back into use in the light. All of this is to get us onto the bridge to the fifth. Now you may say, hey, you know, I'm over here, my twin's here, I feel like I'm halfway to the fifth dimension. Or even have people that say, we're in the fifth dimension, I can feel it. Well, the consciousness of the fifth dimension is here. And there's no doubt about it, there has been a shift, an internal shift, but you're not actually in the fifth dimension. To be in the fifth dimension for twin flames, you actually have to merge your bodies together. In the fifth dimension, we will have new cities, we have new entities that we will encounter, we have new devices to use for our convenience, and we have new healing processes, because even though you have a light body, that's not to say that your light body can't get hurt. Your light body does get hurt, but the difference is when we're in the third dimension, there's a density that holds things into place and hardens it and makes it fester into cancers or tumors or broken bones or something like that. The healing processes in the fifth, by comparison, are extremely accelerated, if not almost instantaneous. Where you're at with this is, for most twins, the one twin is actually expanding and has made their connections at the third and fourth dimensional level for everything that we intend to bring with us. The other counterpart is usually had a connection to the fifth. A lot of times that one feels like they're dangling, but they're not actually. It's like having one foot in and one foot out. And where we're going with this is you've made your connections. Let me get a little pen here. You've made your connections, and usually it's been the one counterpart is making the connection over to the 6th, the 7th, the 9th, the 10th, 11th, and 12th dimensions. I don't know if you can see my diagram there. Oops. Okay. So, here's my diagram taking us all the way to the 12th and source. Okay. Now, what happens? Well, this person frequently is the one laying down, going to meditations, in other ways, getting their light body all prepared, while this counterpart frequently is the one in, you know, they're out in the work world, they're going to bars, they're going to games, they are sometimes still engaging in older energies, and what's happening, that's been unplugged. Anything that's not usable, there are certain female issues and certain male issues that are no longer usable for us. For the large part, the immense mental body that we've been dragging around like a file cabinet isn't useful to us anymore. So we've actually archived quite a bit of the energy, quite a bit of your experiences into the Akashic Records. They're there for you to draw upon as necessary. Now, all the while that your bodies are getting cleaned out, you have different memories pop up, and there'll be memories of dying, having diseases in other lives. You may be feeling things mirrored from your twin of their experiences as it's going. And a lot of times it's like this. You have an experience here that's really dense, but in order to get it out, you've got to screw something in there in order to pull it out and get rid of it and have it transmuted forever. Now, what is waiting for us in the new earth? In the new earth, we have entirely new connections. We have cities that are very familiar to us because they are the fifth dimensional level of a lot of cities that we either have lived in or already live in. Some people don't have an awareness of this, and that's okay. This isn't science fiction, and it's still not rocket science. This is about the love. Because wouldn't you love to be in love where there's no tedium, where the mundane actually becomes an adventure, where doing any little thing with your twin is actually fun and exciting and possibly even romantic? Well, that's the way it is in other levels. It's not that we don't live life. It's not that we don't travel. It's not that we don't have dinner parties. When you have a dinner party, you just don't clean up the dishes. You dismantle the dishes. There are people here that more than likely you've already connected with who are also connected to the fifth dimension. They will be people where you feel the same vibe, you feel your heart chakra open, you feel energetic exchanges with them. It's different than feeling like you're going to, say, your family's house. So it's a party at Aunt Bertha's house and you're going reluctantly. You're going reluctantly because you feel like you can feel the energies when you go there, and you feel like you are actually vacuuming everyone off when you go. Won't be like that anymore. You've been sealed and purified for the most part, and if you haven't yet, ask for it, because you can be. You're not here to vacuum off everybody's stuff. They're here to vacuum their own stuff. You vacuumed your stuff and paved the way for them. So service to humanity is ended. Service to the angelics is almost concluded for many people and concluded for some. And full final merging with your twin is what's expected. There are devices and other conveniences. And I'm going to stop now, and we will cover this in another episode.